Hello, my name is Joshua Gould. I'm a senior instructional designer at Rutgers University under the Office of Information Research Technology. Today, and in this series of videos, we'll be discussing Kaltura, the online video platform. More specifically, we'll be looking at their MediaSpace and CaptureSpace applications. But this video is going to serve as an introduction. We're going to go over the broad strokes of what Kaltura is, how to navigate their online interface, and our first impressions. So let's get started. So what exactly is Kaltura? Well, Kaltura is the world's first and only open source online video platform. This includes media capture and management. Also, Kaltura's API allows us at Rutgers to develop custom players and framework for video hosting and sharing. Here at Rutgers, we can use Kaltura to create and share videos online. This can help us increase student engagement. We can create media-based curricular items that can be integrated directly into LMSs the university already uses, like Sakai. We can measure engagement with analytics on the back end. We can also connect with potential students, alumni, and the community within these channels. Kaltura has published a wide array of tools for video. However, in this series, we'll be looking at just two of probably the most pivotal pieces of application Kaltura has. That's their MediaSpace. This is a video portal, very similar to a YouTube-type interface, where users can create, upload, share, search, browse and watch live and on-demand videos, presentations, screencasts, and other media content anywhere, anytime through their browser. And secondly, we'll be looking at Kaltura's CaptureSpace application. This is a desktop recorder that enables easy recording, capable of capturing complex, multi-source presentations, allowing the user to capture video, audio, and screen in parallel. If at any point you have additional questions, Kaltura actually has a very large support community. They have online forums, FAQs, and a learning center complete with video tutorials for exploring their applications on your own time. I'll put where to find these resources here. We begin exploring Kaltura by looking at the media space. This is the video portal. It's a video-centric repository for media collections across the Rutgers community, where users can publish lectures, teaching materials, and any sort of media for class or coursework. We access Rutgers' media space by navigating to the following address, ru-stream.rutgers.edu. Then it'll redirect us to a page that has the Rutgers seal in the top left corner, some channels below. In the top right, we'll see a search toolbar, as well as two drop-down menus that say Add New, and the other one Guest. The rest of the page is actually blank, as it should be, for our media space is restricted to authorized users only. To log in and access the content, we're going to need to click on that top right drop-down menu titled Guest. From here, we'll see an option entitled Log In. Go ahead and click on that. You'll notice that it then brings us to the CAS. The Central Authentication Service for Rutgers, where your NetID and password will be authenticated. After you've been authenticated and log in, you'll be redirected back to the homepage, where that once blank white space is now populated by a tiled set of images. These images together are called a gallery, and each image represents its own media file. Galleries are centrally curated categories and subcategories that can be found in different channels that makes it easier for content segregation and discovery. So you see at the top, we have different channels such as different schools at Rutgers, different universities, so on and so forth. Below the channels and categories on our homepage will always be generated media items or a gallery. Right now, this gallery consists of ATS media files from our newer campus. No need to worry. In the future, our administrators will be working on populating the homepage with relative media and trying to also direct you to your specific campus. There's just a few more things to cover about the homepage and the general navigation before I move on. We've already covered the general layout, which is the Rutgers branding at the top with channels and categories. We've got the gallery in the main set of the homepage here with media files. And in the top right, we've covered one of the three items I'm going to address now. That's the login drop-down menu on the far right that we use to log in through our NetID. And in that drop-down menu, we'll also see a My Media, My Playlist, and My Channels option, as well as a Log Out function. Next to that, we have an Add New drop-down menu. In here, we can add media files to MediaSpace. We can also launch CaptureSpace from this menu. We'll be covering that in another video. Finally, we have the search bar. Here, we can do all sorts of search functions, in which keywords will access metadata in our media files and make searching easier. In later videos, I'll go over the processes in which we upload and share a lot of our content on MediaSpace, and we'll also discover other pages like the My Media and My Playlist sites. But for now, I wanted to go over the next step in just simply exploring MediaSpace, and that's directing us to media file pages themselves. Now, to view any specific piece of media, all we need to do is click on the corresponding thumbnail, and it'll redirect us to that page. So for instance, if I click on any thumbnail in this gallery, I'll be redirected to that media files page. Let's go ahead and click on one of these. So we've been redirected to that specific page for the media file. Instantly, you'll notice the video player, pretty standard. We have a play button, a scrub bar where we can jump to different positions in the timeline, volume adjustment. To the right of the video player, that small gear or cog represents the playback or data rate options, full screen, and the Rutgers branding in the bottom right. Below the video player is a bunch of metadata and other functionality surrounding the piece. We have the title, the author, when it was posted, two tabs, one is a details, the other is a share option, which we'll cover later, tags that the video may have attached to it, and specific places in which this piece of media appears on MediaSpace, so if it appears on a specific campus or channel. Below that, we have a comment section, and to the right of the title, we see a view count, a total comment count, and an actions drop-down menu. Now, this actions drop-down menu, along with some other functions on specific media file pages, may change depending on your permissions. If you're the author of the media file, you may have a ton of more options under the actions drop-down menu. Hopefully, this video helped to serve as a good preface for what Kaltura is, and more specifically, how we navigate MediaSpace. Stay tuned because in future videos, I'm going to go over a lot of the processes and functionalities surrounding MediaSpace and CaptureSpace and ways in which we can upload, edit, and share our pieces of media through MediaSpace and how we also use the desktop plugin and tool CaptureSpace. So check out the other videos in this series. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to contact me or use any of the resources previously listed. Thanks again.